Today we are going to learn few full forms from C.A. Rachana Ranade. So let us start. What is the full form for MTH?
MTH.
Okay. So what is the full form for GTH?
Go to hell.
Okay. Now tell me, what is the full form for ETH?
ETH? You want to know that? Now, I'll give you a clue. That's how it looks like. Hey folks, C.A. Rachana Ranade here, and I welcome you all to another interesting lecture, which is about what is Ethereum and how is it different from Bitcoin. Well, to put in simple words, Ethereum is a decentralized, open source, blockchain system that features its own cryptocurrency. Now, I'm sure these four words might be a little bit confusing for you. But if you have watched all my previous videos about cryptocurrencies, I'm sure you might be familiar with all these words. But just to quickly revise, I'll quickly tell you one by one. The very first one, it's decentralized. Decentralized means what? The power is not in the hands of a single person, but power is distributed amongst various nodes or peers. Second one is, it's an open source. What is open source? It's available to all. It's not secret as such. Okay, it's accessible to many. Third one, it's a blockchain system. Now, what is a blockchain? I've talked about this in this video in detail, but then in simple words, it's a distributed ledger, and that ledger contains a lot of information which is packed into blocks, and all these blocks are chained to each other, and that's why it's termed as blockchain, right? And what is the last word? Last word is that it features its own cryptocurrency. Which cryptocurrency? ETH. So Ethereum is not a cryptocurrency. ETH is a cryptocurrency, also known as Ether. Okay, then what is Ethereum? Is what I told. Ethereum is equal to these four words. Or to put it in a simple way, Ethereum is an open source blockchain system, or simply put, it's a platform. Okay, what do I do with this platform? This platform can be used for various dApps, which can be deployed by using smart contracts. Now, two buzzing use cases of these dApps or decentralized apps are DeFi's and NFTs. I think the last 15-20 seconds went like... If you want to understand these in detail, just check the next part of the video. Now, let's understand what are dApps or decentralized apps. But to understand what is a decentralized app, let me first take an example of only app. Simple example can be of shadi.com or any other matrimonial app. What happens? There is Mr. XYZ and Miss ABC, whatever. And just that they can meet each other over various apps. There is one app here. Okay, now what this app does is that the main thought process is just to do matchmaking. Okay, and are they going to earn some commission in between? Yes. Why? Because they facilitated these two people meeting each other. That is the only reason why they earned some money in between. Number one. I'll give you another example. Okay, what is another example? Another example is completely different of Google Drive. Now, you can imagine what had happened with Google Drive just few months ago. Can you remember that? I remember all my important documents which were hosted on Google Drive. They went for a toss. Why? I could not access my own Google Drive. Google was down. Google Drive obviously was down. YouTube obviously was down. And I was like, oh my God, that was a big nightmare. Now you can imagine these apps have complete centralized authority. This single entity controls so much part of my life. Now, if this centralization is taken away, then what? So that's where comes in the picture that there is no centralization. In simple words, there is decentralization of what? Of apps. So no single entity is going to control the app, and that app is not going to earn commission just for the matchmaking purpose. Right? Now, can I create my own app? Yes, it's very simple. Step number one, just understand how the decentralization works. Step number two, just write a code that mimics the same behavior. And step number three, just get a huge network of computers to run this code. That's it. And here comes the solution. Introducing Ethereum, not a currency. A platform that provides us the infrastructure that has thousands of independent computers, that is nodes which are running. Well, once a program is deployed over this network, it will ensure that it gets executed as written. Well, now if I want to create my own decentralized application, I have to ensure that no single person controls this. And for this, all I need to know is a programming language. Which language? C, C++, Java? No, I need to know Solidity, which is the coding language of Ethereum. Now, once coding is done using Solidity, all I have to do is deploy it on EVM. What is EVM? Ethereum Virtual Machine, which is a blockchain-based software. So I hope by now you have understood that what Ethereum provides us with. Ethereum provides the developers with various tools that can be used to make dApps or decentralized apps. Is it clear till now? So in simple words, what is Ethereum? Ethereum is not a currency. Ethereum is a platform. Then which is the currency? ETH or Ether is the currency. Then what is the connection between these two? Array, wait. On the Ethereum network, there are thousands of computers who are either approving or disapproving transactions. Are they doing this for free? No. These nodes need to be incentivized. Incentivized using which currency? ETH or Ether? Well, just on a separate note. Do you know what is this? Yes, that's BTC, Bitcoin. What is this? That's ETH or Ether. And what is this? That's the like button. You need not pay Ether or Bitcoin to smash the like button. It's free of cost. If you do that, YouTube understands that you are loving the video and will recommend to more and more people. That's the way you are helping others to learn more about cryptocurrencies. So now coming back to that point where three words went completely as a bouncer. Number one, I talked about dApps. Number two, I used the word DIY. And number three, I used the word smart contract. Now, I hope you are aware about what's a dApp. What's a dApp? Decentralized app. Not a single person is going to control that, right? Second one is DIY. Another short form or full form coming up for you. Now,
Madam, one more. Huh? What is the full form of BTH?
BTH? Batli taakya thante. Now don't disturb me. Okay. So what is DIY? DIY is do it yourself. Okay. So either I can actually learn the language Solidity. Okay. Or I can hire engineers to whom I will instruct that you learn the language of Solidity. I'll pay them handsomely, right? And what they are going to do? They are going to write smart contracts. Now you'll be like, what are these smart contracts now? That's what exactly I'm going to tell you. Smart contracts are nothing but contracts which can execute themselves. You'll be like, how can a contract execute itself? In simple words, smart contracts are contracts which have a lot of ifs and thens. Now, what is this if and then? I'll give you a simple example for this. Right now, I gave you an example of Google Drive. Okay, wherein there is absolute centralization. Everything is in the hands of Google. Okay, now I say, I don't want G Drive. I want R Drive. Okay, that R Drive app is not a centralized app. It's a decentralized app. So who is going to control that? Me? No, thousands of nodes, thousands of computers are going to control the decision making here. Okay, now what happens, understand, the coding in this app is done in such a way that there are lots of if sentence. Means what? Let's understand. If you want a part of that drive space on rent, you are going to pay me and I'm going to give that space on rent to you. Okay. So what will be written in the contract? If I receive money, then you will get the space on rent. Okay. What will happen in real world? There'll have to be a person who passes the accounting entry, who will actually take the money, who will actually give the drive space to you. But here, who is going to do that? The contract itself is going to execute. That's why it's known as a smart contract. I hope you have understood here. No human intervention as such. The contract itself is going to execute itself, wherein ifs and thens are the main thing. Going back again to those bouncer words, which were these? DIY? Check. Now you know that. Smart contracts? Checked. You know that. DAP? Check. You know that. And then we talked about the two use cases. Which were the two use cases? One is DeFi and one is NFT. We have not talked about these. First, let's try and understand what is DeFi. To be really honest, if I start with the definition of DeFi and all that, it can be pretty confusing. I'll try and simplify this concept with the help of a simple example. Okay, let's understand this case that there's Mr. A and Mr. B. Mr. A has excess money and Mr. B is in need of money. Who is going to do the matchmaking? It's a bank. Okay, but here, bank is a centralized authority. Entire power is concentrated in the hands of a bank. Can this bank go away and can there be a platform on which some decentralized app is built which can directly connect Mr. A and Mr. B? Okay, so this can be an example of what? Centralized finance or decentralized finance? If they are getting directly connected with each other, that will be an example of decentralized finance. I'll give you one more example. Okay, Mr. A, Mr. B, they want to do trading. Okay, now if I'm talking about trading of shares, I need a central authority again. Which is a central authority? NSC or it could be BSC. Okay, all powers are concentrated in the hands of whom? In the hands of the exchange. Now, instead of this, if there is again a platform on which a dApp is built, wherein this person and this person are directly connected with each other, wherein they can trade with each other. Answer is yes. And this is also an example of DeFi. Now, are there some websites which I can show as an example? Answer is yes. So, just as an example, for the banking one, I can give you the example of Aave.com. So, Aave.com, now what is it? It is very clearly mentioned. Aave is an open source. I've talked about this word. Open source, non-custodial liquidity platform for what? Earning interest on deposit and borrowing assets. Oh, so like I told you, the person who had excess money, what is he going to do? He is going to earn interest on deposits. And the person who wanted money is going to borrow the assets, right? So if you just scroll down here, you can see, I'll give you an example of a stable coin, which is USDT coin. What can you do? You can either borrow this or you can deposit this. Even rate of interest is also given. Okay, so can this be a classic example of DeFi? Answer is yes. Now, I'll give you another example. Another example of what? Instead of an exchange for trading, right? What is an example? Uniswap. What is given here? It's a decentralized trading protocol and it's running. So, what is given here? It's a guaranteed liquidity for millions of users and hundreds of Ethereum applications. So, well, I can go on talking about this, but I hope you have understood this. Whenever time permits, you can go through this website. What is it an example of? It's again an example of DeFi, where there is no centralized authority. There's just a platform on which a dApp is built, which directly connects two people. Now, what are NFTs? NFTs are digital assets and ownership of which is recorded publicly on a blockchain. Didn't understand? Let's take an example. Now, this picture or a caricature was gifted to me by one of my friends. Now, what could happen potentially? Let us understand. Once I upload this, people will immediately start doing copy paste, and a lot of replicas of this same image will be created. And everyone can say, I did this, I'm the true owner of this. Okay, now if my friend were to tell that, hey, I am the OG creator of this specific photograph, what could he have done? He could have uploaded this photograph as a digital asset on a blockchain and he would have recorded that, hello, I am the original person who created this. Now, does he only know about this or now the world knows about it? Now, the world knows about it because it's on a blockchain. So, that is why this specific photograph becomes original. It becomes non-replaceable. That is nothing but non-fungible. So I hope you have understood very nicely what is Ethereum. I hope it's fixed into your mind that it's a platform. It's not a currency. It's a platform on which dApps can be built, wherein smart contracts are an integral part of that. And two amazing use cases we talked about it was DeFi and NFT. Now you know a lot about Ethereum. If you are already aware about Bitcoins, well and good. If you're not aware about what is a Bitcoin, you can just check out this video. And now let's move on with the distinction of Bitcoin versus Ethereum. So let's understand this distinction using few points. Who is the founder of Bitcoin? Technically speaking, anonymous, but people use the name of Mr. Satoshi Nakamoto. Ethereum, there are many co-founders, but one of the co-founder is Vitalik Buterin, who is pretty famous. Second one, if I'm talking about supply, is there any limitation on supply? The answer is yes. Bitcoin maximum supply is 21 million Bitcoins. For Ethereum, it's an unlimited supply, but maximum new ether, okay, here I should not be using Ethereum, maximum number of ethers which can enter into the market are capped at 18 million per year, okay. Next one is the transaction time. How much transaction time is required on a Bitcoin blockchain? It's roughly 10 minutes per transaction. But on the Ethereum blockchain, one transaction can be executed in barely 15 seconds. Next one is Bitcoin is used as what? What is the true value? Bitcoin is in itself is just a store of value, nothing else. Okay, but if I'm talking about Ethereum, the value of Ethereum lies in its blockchain. It can be used for multiple purposes. It's upon you and me. It's upon various software engineers and all those geeks, how they can use this blockchain, how they can use this knowledge to build various dApps on this blockchain, right? Next one, what is the application of Bitcoin? It's just used as money, but Ethereum, I talked about so many applications, including two amazing applications, which is NFT and DeFi. Next one is fees. Okay, how much reward is given to the miner? 6.25 BTC is given as a reward to the miner, and for Ethereum, it's 2 ETH per block. Crypto asset of your choice, just check out the WazirX app. Link is there in the description box. They have an amazing feature which is known as the quick buy. So what you have to do is just open the app, hit on quick buy, select whichever crypto asset you want to, enter the amount and swipe to buy. And there you go. It's that easy. Don't forget to apply the promo code CryptoRachna and the first 500 users will get one WazirX token absolutely free of cost. Well, did you know that Ethereum 2.0 is on its way? So if you want me to make a separate video on that, do let me know in the comment section. Till then, keep learning. Take care. Jai Hind and bye-bye.